Good afternoon, Baker College graduates, families, friends, and colleagues. I am so grateful to be here with all of you today from wherever each of you may be enjoying this virtual ceremony. My name is Dr. Bart Daig, and it is my great honor and privilege as the president of Baker College to address our graduating class on commencement day. Today, we have come together, though far apart, to celebrate the outstanding achievement that is completing a degree from Baker College. To the class of 2021, not only have you demonstrated the determination and fortitude required to complete a college degree, you have shown considerable strength and resilience by doing so during the challenges of a global pandemic. Your courage and resolve are to be applauded. I am confident you will take with you from your years at Baker College an education that will serve you well throughout your life, wherever your path may lead. Knowledge, confidence, critical thinking, effort, and teamwork will take you far. On behalf of the very proud Baker faculty, administration, and staff, we can't wait to see the places you'll go. Though the challenges ahead may, at times, seem daunting, believe in yourself and the power of your accomplishments. The world is yours. Decide how you'll leave your mark. To the Baker College graduating class of 2021, I commend you for your efforts and achievement. Congratulations, good luck, and thank you for being part of the Baker family.
Hello, I'm Dr. Jill Langen, Provost for Baker College. The time surrounding graduation is always exciting, and attending the commencement ceremony and speaking with graduates is one of the best parts of my job. Annually, I speak about the traditions of commencement, the significance of caps and gowns, and I try my best to provide some wisdom and advice to graduates. Last year, however, was a unique year. Instead of joining graduates in a large arena with lights and music and thousands of guests, I shared a message recorded in my living room. There was uncertainty about what the future would hold, a fear of what the coming months might bring, and a recognition that the upcoming year would be the most challenging we have ever faced. And now, a year later, I am still not in an arena, but at least I am out of my living room. The graduating class of 2021 is unique. Earning a college degree is never easy, but the challenges and obstacles you have overcome are the likes of which we haven't seen in generations, and hopefully we'll never see again. You have faced illness and the loss of loved ones. You have provided care for others when needed and found the strength to ask for help when you have been in need. Some of you have lost jobs, while others have worked triple shifts because of critical shortages. Your income has been disrupted, your children have become your students, and your college experience has been turned upside down and inside out. And yet, you have persevered. You have shown what resilience and grit can accomplish. Through it all, you have found the courage and the will to continue, to study, to learn, and to succeed. What you have learned this year has far exceeded what was in any of the course syllabi. You have learned that you are unstoppable, that you can achieve whatever you can imagine. When Baker College first used the phrase BakerProud, we could not imagine what that word would someday come to mean. Being BakerProud reflects resiliency, grit, and determination. It reflects someone who knows how to give their all and then somehow find a way to give just a little more. It defines someone who understands that sometimes we have to sacrifice things in the present to make a better future. You are BakerProud. It is clear that the BakerProud graduates we are celebrating today are people to be admired and respected. And it is clear you will create positive change in the world around you. The entire Baker College team, faculty, administrators, and staff, join me as I say, congratulations, class of 2021.
Hello. My name is Dr. Ryan Starzik, a proud veteran and recent Baker College doctoral graduate. Growing up, I was not a very good student. School didn't come naturally, and I struggled up until my very last year in high school. Between kindergarten and first grade, I had to take a transition class for 1 year because of my reading and math comprehension weaknesses. I remember being given special attention and one-on-one teaching during this period. That transition period helped me regain the skills to keep moving forward, but I still struggled and had to retake geometry during my senior year in high school. While everyone else was getting out of class early, I was there from 7 a.m. until 4 p.m. Monday through Friday. Right after class, I would go home, take a shower, and get ready for work. I worked at a local restaurant cleaning dishes until about 11 p.m. I was up at 5:30 a.m. and walking on the school campus by 6:45 a.m. My mother had to drive me every day because the house we lived in was sold out from under us when my grandfather died. The house was in his name, and my aunt didn't have any desire to allow us to stay. So we moved across town, about 30 minutes away from where we lived. I didn't want to be forced to switch schools during that last semester, and the daily grind of going to school and working at night was hard and exhausting. But it didn't stop me from pressing forward to achieve the goal of a high school diploma. The hard work paid off, and I did succeed in this goal. You see, working hard is a big part of life's adventure. So many times throughout my life, I remember having to do things more than once. That never giving up attitude instilled in me helped with a lot of life's experiences. I served in the military from 2003 until 2007. I was deployed to Iraq twice during this time and saw things that made me realize just how valuable every last breath we take is. There is no freedom without a fight, and no freedom should be taken for granted. In the military, I experienced pervasive bullying because of who I am, a gay man. This went on for most of the time I was in. It didn't discourage me, instead made me a stronger person. The bullying didn't stop me from pushing forward. Instead, it fueled my desire to fight back even harder. This is why I joined the Phoenix Pride Board of Directors and currently serve as the Vice President. If you want to make a change, be part of it. Like I said, there is no freedom without a fight. When I got out of the military, I struggled with severe PTSD and addiction. It took many years of hard work, determination, and love from my partner of almost 14 years to overcome it. I worked tirelessly to finish my bachelor's, master's, and doctorate degrees. The doctorate degree took a little bit longer than I expected, but thanks to the world-class professor at Baker College, the unique opportunity presented with the ABD program, I finished this lifelong dream of becoming Dr. Ryan A. Starzik. A very special thank you to Dr. Vinton, Dr. Houghton, and Dr. Staley for making this dream a reality. Baker College is a place that makes dreams come true, so long as you have the mindset to achieve the goals you set out for. I stand here with all of you as a BakerProud graduate. This year's commencement ceremony is unlike any previous one. Humanity is challenged with a once-in-a-lifetime pandemic that has taken so many lives. All of us know someone affected by COVID-19, which is a testament to how interconnected we are. Failures of leadership brought the global economy to a near-screeching halt. Instead of looking to science for answers, we had a reality TV star giving opinions and recklessly disregarding human life in the process. A breakdown in leadership can result in severe consequences. We continue to see the effects from poor leadership today. I believe leadership is an iterative process. The leaders of tomorrow are desperately needed today. We need leaders that recognize the importance of building bridges, coalitions, and are willing to fight for equal justice under the law. Let's not kid ourselves. There is a lot of unequal justice being unleashed in our society today. It doesn't have to be that way. You can change it. We can all change it. We as a society must change. Today we witness racial injustice, economic inequality, and partisan divisions unlike anything in our history. If you want to make a difference, be willing to take a risk. I took a considerable risk last year by running for state senate in Arizona. I didn't win the primary this time, but I still put up one hell of a fight trying. Like I said before, sometimes things take more than one attempt before you achieve your goal. Don't be discouraged. Instead, let it drive your next try towards success. Now, I'm not suggesting that all of you run for public office. In fact, I would advise talking with a professional therapist to prepare yourself. Just remember, the bridge to a new way of life is made when you build it. Keep in mind that solving problems is easy. It's finding problems to solve that's hard. I encourage all of the hardworking BakerProud graduates to seek out problems that need solving and be the one to do it. Build a team, build a future, and build your next career. Something I've said many times in the past and used as a guiding principle in my own life is only the people who say it can't be done will be the reason why it can't get done. You can do it. You have shown your own capabilities by achieving this first goal in a long line of many to come. Use the power of your degree to create something new that changes the world and society as we know it. I leave you with this famous quote from the late civil rights leader John Lewis. Nothing can stop the power of committed and determined people to make a difference in our society. Why? Because human beings are the most dynamic link to the divine on this planet. Thank you, and may your higher power bless the Baker College graduating class of 2021.
Hello, my name is John Vinton. I'm Dean of Doctoral Studies here at Baker College. I'm honored to be able to congratulate the graduate students of the class of 2021. You know, it's been a difficult year, and I know you and your families have made great sacrifices to achieve this goal. We at Baker, your colleagues, your fellow students, are very proud of this accomplishment. We know that you're going to make a big difference in the future that lies ahead. Now I'd like to turn it over to my colleague to introduce the undergraduate students. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Dr. Na Li. I'm the Dean of College of Business at Baker College. It is my great honor to congratulate our College of Business graduates. Over the past few years, I have watched you grow and achieve so much. The last 14 months have been extremely difficult for many of you, but you are brave, you are persistent, and you are diligent. After overcoming so many challenges, here you are accepting the degree that you worked so hard to earn. You deserve it. I'm so proud of you. I'm very confident that in the coming years, you will become providers, leaders, pioneers, innovators, and influencers. You will make great contributions to your organizations, to your fields, to your families, and to your communities. I can't wait to see you achieve your dreams and goals. Congratulations again. Now, let me proudly present the class of 2021 from the College of Business.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Anka Sala, Dean of the College of Engineering and Information Technology. It is my great honor to congratulate our engineering and information technology graduates for reaching this important milestone. Over the past years, I had the opportunity to watch you grow, overcome challenges, and persevere to meet your end goals. Your hard work and dedication benefited not only yourselves, but our entire college community, and I am excited to see where your passion takes you in the coming years. Congratulations on all you have achieved. And now, here are the class of 2021 graduates from the College of Engineering and Information Technology.
Will the class of 2021 please stand? By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and the State of Michigan, I am pleased to confer upon each of you the degree for which you have qualified with all the rights, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto. Graduates, move your tassels from the right to the left. Congratulations.
Hello, graduates. My name is Dawn Preter, Deputy Chief of Student Affairs for Baker College. On behalf of the Registrar's Office, congratulations. Now that you have completed your degree, you can expect your diploma to arrive in approximately 6 to 8 weeks. You can also visit the one-stop page on the MyBaker portal to order a copy of your official transcript or to order a certified electronic copy of your diploma. We would like to thank you for joining us today. Again, on behalf of Baker College, congratulations on your accomplishment and for becoming part of the Baker Proud.